I want to welcome Maryna.
Hi. Hi, friends. So, I'm happy. So today I'm happy to share my experience with you with using game with using Amazon library from Postgres GenStage for find similar persons in a big database. So let's start. I'm working at Edenlab. Some of you might be workmates that come here. I'm working on changing our medical system. This project is the national care system. It's about storing data of patients in cloud. It's about the deterioration stored in cloud. And probably a few more years, all our medical data will be stored in cloud. And no papers, no papers, indications that nobody can read, only the doctors that type. So our problem is that we had a database. It's not a problem. It's a problem. So the problem that we have a database with a lot of data. It is 30 millions of personal accounts with personal data that determinate person, physical person. It's a last name, birth name, document numbers, tax ID, all things that should determinate persons as one. But very widely spread problem for all medical systems. It's not only for us that data is often is copied, and one person, for example me, can be stored for a few times with the type of mistakes, with the mistakes in documents, with the mistakes in my last name, and the problem that each account costs money, because the system pay money for the accounts, for the declarations, and we should find, so our goal was to find all the similar records, determinate that records is similar enough to matches as one person, and deactivate the oldest one. So we had a very simple infrastructure. We had a Postgres database and Elixir. From some reasons we could not implement some additional search engines. So it's right here on the slides. And we need to get this record that duplicates, deactivated, and all of these actions was on production database because of actual data. And while we do these counts, while we search similar persons, we wouldn't abuse the performance of our prod. So my speech is not only about Elixir, as you understand, but is about Postgres. And it's interesting for me how many persons here use Postgres in their projects. Oh, so cool. It probably will be interesting for you, I hope. So it's about so my speech will be contain a lot of optimization because I have a lot of slides, a lot of text, and not enough time probably, but let's go. So the ones that speak Ukrainian will understand the problem. Same person can be stored like these three records. Because of sound of the last name, because of similarity of document numbers, doctors can do type of mistakes while inputting data, etc., etc. And the last name sound often not that way that they type it. So we have here an example. More prosaic example, it's a very popular mistake, like the sounds of some consonant sounds or vowel sounds stored not that way that it typed first, and the way of storing document numbers. For example, this document could be stored these two ways. And these records become different because it contains different data, but that record determinates same person and its money, so we will find this record. It's an example of popular mistakes, especially for all paper documents, when the one is looks like similar to seven. And one more problem is the field that also identify person, it is birth date. On input on web calendars, it often not usability, and doctors should type 60 times if the patient age is 60, and they often do mistakes in the birthday field. And documents also is not unique enough. Tax ID also is not unique. When the beginning we were hoping that these fields like tax ID, like documents number, will be unique, but in practice it does not work that way. And as I said, it's a popular problem. Many systems, there are many ways to find the fraud, find similar data. But for our medical system, the most popular ways, for example, detective of fraud on financial account based on activity analytics on Markov model is not work for us because our account do nothing, so there is no Markov model changes of states, and we can determine does it account real or duplicated or not. And the second one, that popular method for fraud finding is analysis when accounts created, login, etc., etc. But our accounts created via third-party service. So the batch, the thousand of accounts created in 4 a.m. is a normal situation because our third-party services, we call it MIS, medical information system, work that way. They can load the data at 4 a.m. So we can't use this popular method. And here is example how we are going to determine similar records. It's got one record, second record, and count the score of similarity for this pair. We use a Python model that our system analytics and machine learners did for me. I only used the Python model I sent the flags to this, but it's not my job. So my job was to find, my goal was to find from DB the similar records and the same response. So for example, we have some records that unverified. We are finding similar, count the scores of similarity. If the one of scores is so high that we understand that it is really one person, we deactivate and store our money. So it is very simple infrastructure and we have a limited time to count it. 30 million records, it does not sound like a big data or something like this, but in practice, how we can get all the candidates? Okay, it's a process how we do this process. So we get unverified record, we get candidates from DB, and our goal to get only Z candidates that we know that the similarity is high enough. Async stream is good enough for us because the person counted while the last candidate is counted. And about counting, so how we can find this probably similar records when we don't know the score of similarity before we did not count it? What should we get from DB? It's very expensive for us to count all for all because it creates many pairs with a lot of zeros. I'm not going to count it. It's big enough. And even if one process for one pair will be worked fast, it takes too much years to count it. So it's not good for us. We're waiting or candidate is ready, which will check all for all. And also, of course, there is no reason to check a person with a different last name, no similarity, no with a totally different numbers, etc., etc. So how we can get it? This step should take milliseconds, and the interesting part of my job here was to optimize database and optimize the way of search to do the step in milliseconds, because we have a limited time to count it. We can't wait months or years to receive our bonds. And the ways how we do it. So we do it with exact match of some consequential fields, like a document numbers and types ID, and with some fuzzy match of consequential fields, like last names and difference in numbers, difference in names, etc. So this is the easiest way how to get exact match candidates. It's very easy, it seems very easy. So if we have the record with tax ID like this and number like this, we just find our candidate, it's about exact match, and everything looks good. About the fuzzy cluster, it is more interesting part, because fuzzy counting is the result you did not, as result you did not know. So it's that field that I told already. It is approximate equal name sound. For the fuzzy cluster with this, we implemented the Ukrainian version of double metaphone. If anybody knows what is double metaphone, it's a way of sound some consonant characters after vowel characters. And we create a Ukrainian version, and we handle this two actions for fuzzy cluster. So the next. It's how double metaphone works. For example, this first character sound like S, and writing like this S, and changes like this. And in double metaphone, the ending of last name changes to symbol, to discriminate group. So the similar sound last names will be write one way in double metaphone in the symbols. And we will find by these fields. And this is how my Elixir processes work. So for these countings, I used GenStage. When I started, I tried to use GenServer, but it was not effective, really. As previous speaker talk, the query messages in mailbox and performance is not good enough for me. And also there are additional code to implement the getting data and et cetera, et cetera. So in GenStage, all of this is done for you, and it is SMB, by happy that I finally found it and use it. So we have a producer that generates unverified records. We have consumers that do this process that I talk about, that get candidates for this unverified records, counts the scores of similarity, deactivates if need, or push to message broker, because it's expensive to deactivate same time. And then they consume your record automatically. I did not write some logic to get it, so it's very useful for this case. And this process works until the last unverified record will be counted, and the process will be finally found. All the duplicates and deteriorate. It is the one process, so it's how our one consumer works. And we had 20 of consumers like this. And the beginning, I scaled all this group, the producer with the consumer sets. But there was no practical meaning, because the resources of machine is used by even by this one set. So no need to scale it. It's one producer is enough. Next step. So let's talk about Postgres optimizations. If you're using Postgres in prod, and you are probably faced with some problems of performance or running the queries not the not that plan that you expected. Of course, I'm sure you did not forget to tune your Postgres and Postgres config, extend the shared buffers, extend the work maps, etc., etc. I'm sure you did not forget this. And you can do any optimizations only after the Postgres config is correctly changed, updated to prod, because the standard config is only for dev and on your machine on few records, for example, for tables with 2 gigabytes, but not for tables with 1,000 gigabytes. So, never store status columns for some persons. Try to avoid this. Store some flags flags that works for order, because when you update one field in record, all the record marked as old, but it still stayed before the vacuum cleared it, and a new record is created. So if I create the column with status checked unchecked, the volume of my table will be scaled in 2 times, because every record will be updated to change it. And for big tables, it's not worth. So also less fields, better performances. And the same. Store this plug. Store the plug of check it somewhere, not in Postgres, because it will be fast updated. And Postgres is not the database for fast updates. Fast updates, fast search. It's a relation database, so remember about it. And the simplest way: use the index. Use the index in correct way. So it's an example of two bad requests. Why? Because if you are not asking Postgres to count some integrals for you or differential equivalations, you are not going to ask equivalations like sum if you created the index by this field, because Postgres is don't count equivalations, it's only check the equal values. So to run the equivalation like this, every record in DB will be checked, and if you have 30 million records, it will take many time. And next, it's the correct usage of index when the expression in the right part. And it is a bit another example. When you are using expression in the left way, in the left side of equivalation, why? Because your index was built with some function. So if you build your index with some regex, replace, or some function, please use this expression when you ask your data. This query will run because it used that expression. This query will not run because the index built on expression. Very simple, but it's a popular mistake, very popular mistake. About last slide that I do, and partial index. So if your Postgres is not working with a lot of updates and a lot of inserts, partial index can little bit abuse updates, hot updates and hot inserts. But if your query, your system works, web server is more for queries, use partial indexes. For Postgres, it is easy to check 7 small files to detect your data, then check 1 big file, because 1 big file will definitely run slower, you can check it. So if you are using, you can define, you know that type, you have the limited types, for example, 5 types, 4 types, you can build the partial index, and it will run very fast. And about query optimization. What if you did all the best indexes, all the best configuration, and your query runs still slow? It is also quite a widespread problem when the index exists, index is correct, but query still run slow. Postgres is not MySQL, and you can force Postgres, force query runner to use some index with the command use my index. So what, for example, if we have one person and relation one to many, for example, person and documents, when one person can have few documents and your B index is correct, everything is good, but the tables is large and the index is large. And you type very like this. Give me that records with that birth date and with that numbers. In my case, I have a partial index for type and number created like this, but I get first time I get time of executions like this, 5 seconds, extremely slow. It's not work for me because I have 30 median rows to check. So what the problem is, how we can optimize it? We can, okay, let's check a previous slide. Here we write a search example here on where condition. So we join it tables and then use the build date here in where. We can use our search conditions right on the joins, you see? So we are join on conditions on here and here. And Postgres knows that only that records would join that satisfy that condition. And your index start run, start working, and you have good enough executions for milliseconds. It's good enough, it's fast. And one more different way of query is using subjoins, because not always with that kind of queries, not always correct index is used. So you can use join on subselects, and it will be also fast enough, as you see, almost like this. Many people hate the word join because they do not know how to use it correctly, but join is not bad. Join is join and anti-join is the best and fastest way to get your data. So next. About multi-column indexes. When you build your index on two columns, for example, when both of columns exist in search condition, the few things you must remember before you building it. Order is really matter, and the field with the rarest distribution should go first, because then less the part of file will be read it, then faster you will get your rows. It is an example of the bad index. When you create index by field, that is very popular in table. And random page cost is higher, is almost always higher than reading from the DB. So reading this file with index will take a lot of time, and you will do even worse with the index like this. So this field should go first, because this field has a rarer distribution than last, than type. So I also need to say that yes, there is no silver bullet to that hand some rules that works always, but that rules that I talk about works in almost all cases, but of course it depends on query, on orders, on distribution of data of each field. So before you build index, you must understand the distribution of your data and understand the volumes of part and files that will be checked before the records will be find. Next slide is partitions. Sometimes multi-column indexes and optimizing query is not enough. If both tables are very big, if these tables are inflated, and you check the popular condition in one of table and the second, it is effective to use partitions. Yes, it's for developers a little bit harder to build the index on each partition table, because index are not inherent, but for Postgres it's easy to, as I told, it's easy to check 10 small tables than one big table. So about partition. If many pages will be scanned and index too big, tables too big, and most of accessed rules stored in can be stored in one partition. For example, when the type is passport, for example, or when they insert the tab between months, like your partition created, it is effective. Of course, you if you build partition by that field that not running in query, it will not help you. So you are building that partition that insert. It's example. For example, you have a big table, this table big, and no optimized indexes will help you if the data is very large. So what? How we can scale it? We can create partitions like this, partition by settlement ID. And when you find all the persons with the last name that sound like the record you're trying to verify, and the settlement where the person live, ID, it will be effective. I on my first version of the application, I use partitions for addresses to find rows in few milliseconds. And partition even be created like this. Of course, it's overkill for first name because we have not so big data to partitionate a person's table, but it will be even more effective than preview. So next. Partitions improve operations and it improves performance at all. But for you as for developer, it's a little bit harder to handle the rules for them, indexes for them. But in practice, it will be always improve its performance if some search conditions is used. And even surface update will run faster than on the table. And the next step is denormalization, when you can partitionate some data, or you are not going to partitionate from the perspective of support child tables. You can denormalize it and it's normal. Sometimes it is better to use a few gigabytes on your few, even few 10 gigabytes or whatever you need. It's sometimes much more effective than trying to do something that you can't. For example, if your select will not run fast enough with denormalization, use it. It's normal. Many companies use it for search, so the normalization. When it is, as I told, when your indexes build it on long running functions. For example, my implementation of double metaphone is long running function because it checks all the letters in the last name, all the endings in the last name, and determinates the sequence of characters for this. And it's is abusing a little bit abusing the performance of inserts and updates because even if you update field that not indexes with this function, for example, you build it, I build it double metaphone function bus last name, and I am going to update tax ID field, but this but new record will be created, this function will be counted, it is time, it's cost too much, so it's normal to use partition in this way, not partition, denormalize your data. And if you can't partitionate tables for some fields, because it would be not effective. So then denormalize your data. And it's example when denormalized data is stored that way you need it, it is very fast to get it. Of course, you build some index if you need on this table and you get your data fast, like a charm. So, what details I use it for my what fields I use it for my deduplication? I use it as I told, double metaphone and few impositional attributes, exact match on documents, notifications, and it creates for me 6 clusters that find the record that will be similar. Last name and settlement, last name and birth date, last name and first name, documents matches, phones matches. So one of these fields will should be the same, and my records will be found. So I just created six clusters, but when I tried to write the query first time and describe it all my six clusters, Postgres, what Postgres sees that I am joining big table on another big table and double more big table with the conditions, and the planner is not going to run my indexes. Planner is going to sequence kernel my data and check what finds, because the planner expects that it is too many conditions to check it all by it, and it don't compose the indexes in the way I want. And it is trying to check all the records, and it is only for one person, for one unverified record, and I still have 30 million unverified records. So when I put in together all my search conditions, I also do some optimizations, and the optimization tip that I use is union. So I created a separate queries, and each query matches with some indexes. So this query is separate, and Postgres run it one by one with my optimization. So my optimization is running. If I will put in one where condition, it will not run, as I said. So the union tip is effective thing. If you need to force Postgres, to force planner to use your index. Next one, advices about storing data. Then, when your record is small, when there are few fields only, fast will be the search will be fast enough. If the record is big and you have a I don't know, for example, 20 fields, and you select only one field, but still all your record in Postgres, all the record, all the fields is readed from DB, and only that field that you ask returning. But Postgres read all the record from table. So if the table contained 20 fields, 20 fields will be readed, and it is time, it is performance. So when you store in your data, like JSON, big JSON table, and big JSON data, please avoid do this. And it is better to use some denormalization, move JSON to separate table, just make your table ways smaller. Let your table be smaller, denormalized, but smaller. And the very easy rule also that you should avoid searching some fields by JSON B fields. Even it is indexed, and even the JSON and JSONB fields indexes with GIN, your queries would not be so effective if your data will store it as it should be stored, like separate table, for example. Or if you are going to get all JSON, it's better to join on table and get your JSON or your image or something like this, but big, but records should not be big. Okay, next one. So all rules and tips I'm talking about, we're using. Use it. And I gain the result for a few days. So my deduplication process run during few days, and the persons was counted. We found almost 500,000 similar records that were deactivated, and a lot of records with scores also, the high scores that were checked later. And tips for starting GenStage. As the previous speaker talked about the strategy of the restarting, if you are run GenStage with architecture like mine, with a one producer and few consumers, it is better to use one for all strategy. Sorry, there are type mistakes. There should be rest for all strategy. I'm sorry. Restful, because if the last consumer fails, the previous producer should not be fails, and previous consumer shouldn't fail. I'm sorry, there should be rest for all. And if your application run like some job, there exists a feature of subscription tagging, and you can use it, and you can find the store the subscription tags, and then do resubscribe, because if you don't do this, when the last record is counted, the process of GenStage will be stopped. And during few days, you will save new persons. New data about it will be not checked, because GenStage thinks that all the records is stopped. And it's a code how to start GenStage. And use the subscription tag I talked about. And why I choose GenStage? As I said, it is easy and it is it has a better performance than GenStage. And we see that each consumer takes a different time to count. For example, one record cannot have candidates in and one record can have 90 candidates, and they take more time. And then the consumer says, try to subscribe, and it's what's useful for me to avoid the writing code for getting new data, for producing new data. And why I choose it? Yes, because it's very easy to scale consumers with the adding of powerful online, where the program runs in bare metal or in cloud with some code. Is extending, of course, I can extend the consumers, number of consumers, and the run. As I told, the measurement for persons in each consumer take different times, and it's easy to do that. So, what I will be improving my next steps, I will determinate the consonant pollution. Because double metaphor do not count the consonant pollution. For example, if you type the name and add the consonant chart, it will be different in metaphor. So I'm going to use it. And I'm going to add fuzzy documents cluster. How it will run. It's also a question. Because I don't know the distance, the difference before I did not get the rule, but there exist tips how to get the similar number with the similarity with the difference of one or two symbols. It will be easier to just, it will be better to generate query in Elixir and type search symbols in each number to change it. Because if I will ask well the distance of the records will be checked. And extend my current model with few more fields. Then thank you that you listened to me and did not get enough while I was trying.
Thank you, Maryna. It was pretty interesting to see a lot of SQL on the Elixir conference. But I think it was really interesting. Do we have any questions?
So you removed 500,000 of patients, yes? So, and all of them was a copy, so in the list of deletion records. You say it was like similar persons.
Similar
persons. Yeah, so you deleted them.
I deactivated.
Deactivated them. So, and no one of them was the real one. So you make 100 match of the similarity or mistake or some mistakes of existence.
We did not takes when the model when the model produce results that is not correct. We use at a very high score of similarity. We use a score of similarity almost 95%. It was the same person, in practice, we can even reduce the score of similarity, but we don't do these risks, and so we did not face this problem. We did not deactivate the correct person.
Basically, you didn't know that because you didn't receive any kind of feedback yet.
Yes, we are. No questions.
Hello.
I listen.
You do a lot of optimizations.
Almost all the tips for optimization that were used in this process. Yes.
And how do you test it? Like, you have a similar environment of production? Like, you have the same
problem? We generated a similar environment. We did not use a real person data because it's protected data. I cannot check this data. So we anonymize our data, we change it, and we generate the database, and we tested yes, all of these optimizations were done by it take a lot of time to find out
all these improvements in optimization you keep
yes
in the person in the code version with migrations of active migrations or you
no it's not active migrations it's a process that do selects with that kind of optimizations that I told. So it's not a migration, it's a process that do select, count, and push messages with similar records to message broker. Thank you all for listening.